My string of connections, 4 to 12 suggested, it's to provide the opportunity for the child to acknowledge and reflect the connections they have in their life through all or any of their transitions. So again, we cut hearts out of paper. This time you're gonna need a hole punch because you're gonna place a hole in the top part of the heart because we're going to put a string through this. Now, before you do that, on each heart, we're going to write a person that the child feels a connection to. They don't have to be physically in their lives right now. It could be a previous foster parent. It could be a group home they attended, a person, an animal. I work with a lot of children who are internationally adopted. We put their international country, because they have a connection, an attachment, an affinity for their birth country. China, Mexico, wherever they're from, Russia. So the way this works is I want them to visually see all their connections. You know, what I've seen with a lot of these kids is they feel alone. They don't recognize, they're not able to recognize, number one, all the people in their lives, all the people that have cared about them. They think because they're not with them, they don't care anymore. And if they don't care anymore, they feel worse when they feel and care about them because they think it's their fault. So they're trying to push off emotions and so many feelings. So they feel helpless. So I really wanted to help a child understand that because someone's been in your life does not mean that you still do not care about them, that you still do not think about them, that you still can hold on to them in your heart and love them. Because really what I'm teaching the child is you can care about you and your life and your experience and have compassion for where you've been. So, the way this is gonna work is each heart is written a word. Foster mommy here, mommy Flora, foster mom, foster sister, sister, brother, daddy, birth country China. Can I help you?
Just looking.
Okay.
Thank you.
Mexico. My dog, Sally, my hamster, Rocky, my grandma, Jane, my grandpa, my cousin, and my cousin, Mary. So after the child makes all these hearts, I make sure that the string is long enough to go across their entire room. Because I want them to bring this home and put it across their room and sit and see and bask and know that these are all the people in their life, that they're not alone, that they are connected. So we want to include that birth family. We want to include any foster homes. So this is, as you saw last time when I worked on the narratives, you want to know all the people, the players that have been involved in their lives, and encourage them. And it's interesting to see who a child feels connected to and who they don't feel connected to. You know, I don't feel a connection with my birth mother. Okay. Well, we don't have to put her. We don't want to force ever. But this is also telling, doing this exercise, to really find out, do they have attachments or do they not have attachments? And what or who or what thing or place do they have an attachment to? My bear is the only thing that I feel a connection to. Well, then we're gonna maybe do some treatment in attachment work if there's very few attachments. And help the child recognize that they do have people that care about them, that are connected to them. That maybe they don't feel connected to that person, but that person is bonded with them.